Okay, YouTubers, we got a little bit of a video here today. I had a question from Darlington Farm, who I'm subscribed to, and he asked what a V-stack is. So, let me back out here. Normal chainsaws have either a factory, like on these stills, this is a 460. They have a kind of a whatever air filter. Some of them have a flat filter, whatever. That doesn't really affect a V-stack as much as anything does. The big problem a lot of saws have, especially if you use them with muffler mods, any internal works to the cylinder, porting, polishing, anything like that, you have to compensate your air filter. And some of us just don't like fighting dirty air filters. So what you get is these bases, and they're kind of hard to find. There's a few of us that know where we can get them. If you do need to know, I can, if you private message me, I can send you some information on a couple of companies I know of that can still get a hold of these. They're not manufactured very often, but you have to take a lot of the plastics, and there's little pieces under here that you have to remove to get them. But what you're going to need is this base right here that fits the actual stud width. Right across here is the most critical, because Huskies are different than some of the stills, so you got to be real careful which ones you get. But if you look from this side, you can see right on top here, I'll put the file, you can see right here there's the diaphragms underneath here, underneath this cover. Well, you have to cover this with a filter or you will burn up your carburetor gaskets. So that's one thing that's real critical, is if these saws come with the filtered style diaphragm, you must put a filter in there. Some foam works pretty good. I had a couple of these filters that were cut off short scraps, so I stuffed a couple pieces in there and I clean it out, you know, when I clean out my other filter. Now on mine, the one thing you got to be careful of, and I'll show you here, is this. There's a little plate on stills you got to take out, but these chokes will jam up if you don't set these things right. You've got to be real careful how you set this. But the principle behind one of these, and if you can look, is you can see how much more of a space where my finger is. That's your carb throat right there. Well, this increases the air. And the other thing it does is you figure the bigger your volume, the cooler your air is going into the saw. Because if you look, let me slide over here. This saw's got a muffler mod. These holes have been opened up quite a bit. This cylinder has been base gasket removed, internally polished, so it needs a lot more air to run efficiently and not burn up the cylinder itself. So what I've got, that's what this, I said to ignore this black piece for just a moment. You see this filter here is what normally they fit on there. You take this filter here and it fits on. They're not much good in my opinion. These are pretty much junk when they come from the factory. You're better off get a Fernco coupling. This is just a standard 1¼", which is the outside diameter on, this one's 1¼" on the outside. There's some Huskies that are 1 and an odd number, so you have to kind of be careful. What I do on this is, you see you've got a Fernco coupling, just a standard 1¼" by 1½". You put 1½" by 1½" female slip glue PVC fitting in here, drill a bunch of holes in it to get more air, put this filter system on the outside. I don't really like these filters. They work, but they're not the best. This one's going to be junk piled. What I do once I replace that green filter is, this is just a common insulated winter sock, and you can just use these. These get rid of a lot of the big chunks. You can oil these with motor oil. You know, any, you know, even gear oil works. But you got to make sure they're pretty dry when you wring them out so you don't get a lot. That's why I recommend using, you know, a good WD-40 to spray on there. The WD-40, you got to spray it every day if you're using them real heavy. But on this saw, these studs are pretty long. So I've got a couple of, and you can see this. One thing I don't like on these green filters is how coarse they are. I'm real not impressed with that material. It lets in a lot of fine dust. I just cleaned this one a little bit. I need to spray it out with some more carb cleaner just to get all the junk out of it. But really the big thing that you get a benefit on these saws is the longevity of your air filters. Stock air filters, maybe 4 or 5 hours in dust, pushing it if you got extra bands to keep the steel factory's air filters clean. I just don't like the factory filters because they just, that 4 to 5 hours drives me nuts. I would rather clean once a day. And with this kind of filter, if it gets bad, you take this sock, you have 4 or 5 of these in your Fowler's bag, and you can put 4 or 5 of these in the bag, have them pre-oiled, sitting in a Ziploc, and they last all day for cleaning. You can go 6 hours on a sock and just replace it. I mean, this saw has been really, I mean, this saw is not even that old. This is an 09 model saw. And I'll tell you a little bit of history on this saw. This saw has been run over once on the farm. That was kind of fun. We ran over it with a farm tractor, but what's interesting is I had a Can-Am air filter, similar base, about the same size as this, slid on here. The tractor actually came in, and it didn't have the inner, you know, those Can-Ams aren't solid in here. It actually took this piece and pushed it and actually saved the motor, but busted the gas tank right here. And that air filter was what saved it. So I kind of like to have these V-stacks on here, because if you do get something across here, it most of the time will shove the saw versus actually, you know, if you ran it over with a tractor or something, a lot of times these V-stacks will protect the saw and keep the motor from breaking, and you'll only be replacing the gas tank. But if you guys have questions and need any information, you can always PM me through my private messaging on YouTube. So I thought you guys would like to see this.